Now on Channel 4, in a change to our scheduled programming, we look forward to this year's Judge Hardy Plate Golf Tournament over at Plate Golf World.
Hello and welcome to Plate Golf World with me, Judge Hardy Sr. Today we look ahead to the fourth edition of the Judge Hardy Plate Golf Tournament, the Douglas Wood Championship. But before we take a closer look at the 2016 tournament, let's relive the dizzy highs and drunken lows of last year's event. For those of us who missed this boozy spectacle, and for those who attended but have no memory of it, here are some brief highlights and lowlights of last year's final.
Paul, the Judge Hardy, Kenny Hilly, Steve Swabby, Mikey Swabby, Preacher Man, and Dave the Banker Swabby.
Decapitation leads to instant disqualification. Kenny, your tournament could have been all over right there.
Well, I think, to be fair, it's all over. It's like Stan.
Peter, I'll give us the shit! The fucking devil!
He's got too much, too much to drink, come on.
One word, wild.
No? Why no?
I don't want him to win.
Okay.
That's it, it's all over. We have a champion.
So it appears to have been a degenerate, drunken mess of a final last year, with painful injury, on-course tantrums, and some deathly slow play. Truly disgraceful behaviour. This time around, we are looking for some decorum at this year's tournament and hope to witness some proper sporting behaviour. And hopefully, a final that doesn't last the best part of 2 hours. Here at Plate Golf World, we are also happy to announce that we have several new participants at this year's event. And I'd like to take this opportunity to wish you all a warm welcome. It's wonderful to have you playing at the Douglas Wood Championship, and we hope you shall remain JHPGT members for many, many years to come. With all of these new players on board and about to savour their first taste of plate golf, what better time to have a quick refresher on the basic rules of our beautiful sport.
All players must be dressed appropriately in accordance with plate golf regulations. This poor chap simply hasn't got it right, has he? There. Much better. Hands off, ladies. This man has a game to win. Now we are ready to hit the links.
Rule 2. Point of play.
All players must throw their plates from the tee area or from exactly where they land mid-game. Oh dear, our chap is trying to outfox the officials by employing the fabled Hardy two-step maneuver. Come now, sir. One must keep one's foot exactly in the spot that the plate last landed. There. Much better. Tip-top. Rule 3. Playing etiquette. All standard etiquette rules of standard golf apply to plate golf. Here's our man thinking he can stand wherever he bally well pleases. I say, out of the way, you great oaf! Did you just finish the round without shaking hands? Oh dear, oh dear. Get back there immediately. Now you can return to the clubhouse for that well-earned G&T. Rule 4. Losing your plate. If a competitor cannot locate his plate after a shot within a 5-minute window, that competitor incurs a 5-shot penalty, receives a new plate to replace his lost one, and has to tee off from that hole again. That's right, sir. You better keep an eye on that little beauty. Rule 5. Putting and diving. Is your shot game a little on the rusty side? Then perhaps you can try the deadly and dangerous art of dive putting. Players must execute diving putts from a position which has at least 1 foot on the spot at which the plate last landed. There are 3 popular variations that our man will now demonstrate. The first is the two-handed Yantha, quick release diving style. Well done, sir. The spirit of the Yantha is strong in this one. Just watch out for those ribs. Ouch. The second is the stylish one-handed diving putt, often referred to as the Frenchie. Bravo. Très bien, monsieur. And the third is the two-handed O'Toole dive, favored by our Celtic cousins. Hold on for dear life and give it all you've got, old chap. Ah, Jesus. Fair play to you, man, there. And remember, these shots are recommended for putting play only. Oh, dear me. There's no use in teeing off with one, is there, sir? Rule 6. Out of bounds. If a plate is deemed out of bounds or unplayable, that player must add 1 shot to that hole's final total. Don't fret, my man. You'll be informed of the course boundaries before the start of play. There we have it. All the rules of plate golf. Now, let's get out onto the fairways and have a jolly old time.
With the Judge Hardy Plate Golf Tournament moving to a new venue in 2016, this year's location in the heart of the Angus countryside has offered up an exciting opportunity. For the first time in JHPGT history, we are proud to present a full 18-pin course. So without further ado, let's see what's in store for you all once you tee off from behind the large clubhouse and have a closer look at the Douglas Wood Championship.
Hello and welcome to this course guide to the JHPGT 2016 with me, Ben Licrapo, Stanton. Teeing off from behind the log clubhouse, pin 1 can be located via a short, well-placed drive through the trees. We then dip down to pin 2 before playing straight through the campfire area to pin 3. There is ample room on the 4th pin for a good, solid drive, then it's through into the forest for pin 5, a much trickier prospect than it seems. The front 9 continues through the woods and onto pin 6. Here we find the most physically challenging part of the course, with tough terrain. Pin 7 is located next to the large pillbox gateway. Please be wary of the water hazard hidden between pins 6 and 7, as lost plates will include a 5-shot penalty, as standard regulation dictates. The journey from pin 8 leads us through a long alleyway, perfect for those long, straight drives, which is lined with low-hanging trees on the right and very heavy rough on the left. This section of the course then opens up to find pin 8, located in an open area, leads onto pin 9, that finishes in front of the covered spectators area. After some liquid refreshment and a short comfort break, it's onto the back 9. Here we will see excellent opportunities for the long hitters and the dive putters. Teeing off towards pin 10, we are taken down a long, straight fairway, perfect for those with a steady nerve and accurate aim. Then it's on, between a distinctive pair of trees, through to pin 11. Now, pin 12 might be the shortest found on the back 9, but it's deceptively difficult. Patience, cunning, and a good short game is required here. Pin 13 is found nestled in a perfectly small glade, but be careful as there's heavy rough to both sides on your approach to the pin. Pin 14 is the longest at the Douglas Wood Championship, so keep a cool head and your drives on the target. Pin 15 offers some redemption for the high scores, with a straightforward drive and putt should be achievable in 2 throws. It's then on through the trees to pin 16, which sits out in the open with soft ground underfoot. It has perfect dive putting conditions. Pin 17 and 18 are relatively short affairs, with the back 9 concluding near the covered spectators area. Well, that completes this course guide to the JH PGT 2016. May I wish you the best of luck to all competitors at this year's event. Thank you for watching.
So here we are. We've relived the horror and the glory of the 2015 final, had a quick run through of the rules, and even had a bird's eye view of this year's course. The only thing left for me to do is to wish you all an enjoyable tournament, and I'll see you next time, right here at Plate Golf World. Oh, and before I disappear, here's a few stirring words of sporting inspiration from the 2015 champion, Michael Pikey Mikey Suave. I've been Judge Hardy Sr., and if you have been, thank you for watching, and goodbye for now.
Let me tell you something you already know. The Judge Hardy Plate Golf Tournament isn't all sunshine and rainbows. It can be a very mean and nasty sport, and I don't care how tough you are. It will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently, if you let it. You, me, or nobody is going to hit hard as Plate Golf does. But it's not about how hard you throw, it's about how well you can throw and keep moving forward. It's how much you can take and keep moving forward. And that is how winning is done. Now if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you got to be willing to hit those pins, take the dive putts, not point fingers and blame other people. Cowards do that. That's not me. I'm better than that. And that is why I am the Judge Hardy Plate Golf Champion. And that is why I'm going to win again this year.